Hey guys, I'm the Galen here, and today we're going to see if my 84 Alex Collins is underrated or not.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it
I've
goes.
Just been wondering because he's rated an 84, but he breaks like a lot of tackles, and he's just all around a great player.
And now the Falcons on a 1st and 10, getting ready to go on offense. On 1st down, Ryan. He hits his target. It's the tight end, Toilolo. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. A gain of 6 there on 1st.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Falcon 1st down, Ryan to his young tight end, Hooper.
Like so many tight ends nowadays, they're
this is on ultimate team.
Putting him in the slot and letting him go to work, and that's a nice
one of the ultimate team playoff, one of the playoff challenges.
1st and 10, it's Ryan. Ryan hit,
shook
and he lost the football.
Yeah. Safety.
And this will be recovered at least by the offense, but he'll be taken down in the end zone, and that is going to be a safety.
Well, I'm not totally privy
okay, let's see.
To what went on.
Should go right to
meetings,
another kick.
Charles,
it out.
Something tells me that one wasn't in the plan.
Yeah, when we had our production right, meeting, they didn't exactly share that with us. But I'm pretty sure that on the play sheet, the run backwards into your own end zone play was not written down.
So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
Let's go. The run play. Okay, stretch. Here he is right there. Collins got the ball now.
Give right to Collins. And some room to roam now. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be 2nd down.
Some runs are blocked so well.
I want you guys to tell me if you guys think he's overrated or underrated.
It's leveraged by the offensive line to create space up front.
Just tell me in the comments.
Just 1 yard to go here on 2nd down.
This is only my 2nd game playing with him.
Here we go.
Now it's Watson, the bootleg, flush to his
get
right.
Up. 1 second.
And almost intercepted. He could have picked it, maybe some space to go the other way. Instead, it's 3rd down.
Oh, Collins. Yeah.
Tremendous coverage there.
I'm gonna see how good he is with
the catch the
script.
Football, complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Oh, it's a screen pass.
He works on tackle. Ah, my bad. I tried to spin.
Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's
I'm sorry if you can hear like a loud noise in the background. It's just my washer.
And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart, because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield who can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer. As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football.
This video is probably
sometimes
mostly just going
to
be me trying to give it just feed Collins.
On that play and picks up a 1st down with a nice throw.
Might hit Rudolph.
On 1st down, it's Watson. And Rudolph has it, the tight end.
Come on, hurry up, hurry up.
The 30 down to the 25. 11 more yards that go around, a 1st down as well. Now a 1st down throw, Watson. Now they set up the screen, that's complete.
And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. A nice little screen. They get six on first down. Now the offense going to use the first of their time.
Oh, sorry, out of bounds.
As the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. So the offense readies for
and of course,
a
this game I'm not doing as good. I haven't missed my punt return last year. Last game I took him back at, for like a 80-something yard punt return. Touchdown.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half.
Yeah, I'm sorry again for my washers. Just throw it out. Hit karma. Yeah, leave a comment in the comment section of what kind of videos you guys want.
On first and 10, Watson. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And here he'll get it down to the 7. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call.
Should I go right with the gut with him? I'm gonna try to draw.
Not time enough for a play and then a timeout, you wouldn't think. So with 4 seconds left, they're going for it.
I doubt he's gonna get it though. Oh, he's probably not gonna get
it. Oh,
I'm gonna put the other way. But I still got it.
His way into the end zone for a touchdown. Alex. Extra point forthcoming.
Go for extra point. Good.
And this is good as they extend it out now to a 9-0 lead. So that drive takes him down the field in a
I'll just kick it. Scoop kick.
And in the end, it's capped off by a 7-yard run. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Short kick. One of the
upper
he's
back
one. And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks at the 44-yard line.
Okay. Right.
Hang on here. We'll jump over halftime. Just let the system and graphics catch up. Okay, all set. Third quarter now. What a spin.
Yeah, just tell me like what views you guys want. I'll try and make them. I haven't uploaded in like a month. Just because I've been busy. Just trying to count right here.
On first down, Watson. Drops it underneath for Collins.
Breaks two tackles, three.
And he takes no, this with just shy of midfield.
Look, see? Look, 84.
A good pick
like,
up there
I think he's way underrated for 84.
So many times
I don't know what his highest card is, but if it's like
game, get your
90 something, imagine
that
would be stupid.
That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner.
Let's see how he's at wide receiver. Like deep passes.
Here's Watson. He'll rifle this one deep right side.
That's what I'm going to say.
Incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
So yeah, and I know you guys probably going to be trying to roast me in the comment section saying, oh, you're only going against NPCs or, oh, you're not, oh, or the team, the defense, the Falcons that you're playing against isn't that good, all the trash. Yeah, well, I'm really doing this because I'm trying to get coins. And yeah, I've already. I said earlier. I said this is the second game that I've used him in, and the first game I was actually playing online, and he is still doing the same thing. And this is our normal roster. Yeah, this is Falcons' normal roster. So like they might only have. An 85 cornerback and yeah,
always
cornerback on defense,
the
and then
the second half,
they might have a wide receiver at
a bit and get some
I don't know,
and now we find out about
like Sanu might be in a 99.
Right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
Yes, a new.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Julio Jones. I think Julio Jones is like a 9. He's a high 90.
Six. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line.
See, he's only 71.
Here comes the Falcons offense. It's their first possession of the second half now. They just yielded a touchdown on the other end. Now they'll be trying to answer the bell and get a score of their own.
Like DeMarco, like the running back. He's pretty good. I'm in Madden's rating.
Kenny Clark breaking through to get him for a loss of 7. Defense went 3-4. They got some push from the inside.
And this is something in a 3-4 you don't normally get because the nose tackle who got the sack, he's usually responsible or it's getting double teamed and sometimes triple teamed. How about him working his way back and putting the big guy on the ground?
23 yards on the play.
One of the selling points of the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
Back now in Atlanta.
Is right in the middle.
They'll throw on first down with Ryan.
Come on.
Sunu with a grab over the middle. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. Now Ryan. He goes underneath to Freeman. To gain a 5 on the play, and that'll bring up second down. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. Throwing again, Ryan. Hits his target, it's Taylor Gabriel. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Ryan finding Gabriel for the Falcon first down. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Now Ryan on first down. Swings it out to the flat for Freeman. And down inside the 15.
Just off 32, just falling nowhere.
Another nice gain, 16 yards there. And a first blitz. Down again. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Throwing now, Ryan on first down.
Yup, you saw that, Lawrence Taylor. He broke, Matt Ryan broke the tackle. When he was getting up, he tripped him up. Okay,
touchdown counts for their team.
Oh,
but I think it counts more for the fantasy.
I didn't know I just framed the return.
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at.
Like that field goal return.
This one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
So two scores down, time definitely not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. And this is going to be
I really just gave that to them.
And that should just about put a capper on this one. They knew they needed a miracle.
Now let's do what the actual video is about. Let's go.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did, indeed. I think we're down to none. They run with Collins.
I didn't see him over there. I was going to say. I just see, like, how he can make a play, like a dive. Let's see what he does. Dive is supposed to be 3 to 5 yards. Let's see what he can make out of that. I got stuck on the line. I take it back.
Scrimmage, but that's all. The Falcons going to use another timeout.
That'll
leave
them
with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. 10 yards still left on second down. Collins running it from the pistol, spinning away.
My fault.
Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Don't tell me backers, yeah. Switch it up. Cut it out, Yamba. Ah.
As he stopped behind the line, he loses 5 full yards to bring up 4th.
Can I stretch again?
They'll try the right side with Collins. And this doesn't end well at all as they stop him far behind the line to gain. But Charles, it's great to win at home in the NFL. When you win on the road, it's a little extra special, isn't it?
Of course, that game I did horrible with him. But he had a couple good games. Like a couple good plays, but not nearly as good as he was last game. Okay, here's my offense. I know I gotta work on my line, but Sean Taylor, Christian McCoy, Terrell Carmichael, he's like one of the fastest wide. I mean, he's I think the fastest wide receiver. What's his name? K. Yeah. You guys know KK's? I don't really know how to say it. It's like K-A-Y and then K-A-Y and then E-S. Check out his channel. Yeah, he's the one that, he actually made a whole video about Terrell Carmichael being like the fastest wide receiver. Bobby, Lawrence Taylor, that's one that I was playing with. And Tyron Matthew. Trevor Williams. Melvin Jones. They actually, in Madden 18, they're giving them a whole bunch of them out. So, I think everybody got one, actually. Justin Coleman. And then Kenny Clark. That's trash. Russell. See, there's a better version. Talking about Bruce Smith right here. David, I'm not even gonna try and say his name. Stephen Tuitt, Brooks Freed, and Champ Bailey. This one's the one that you can also unlock. He's not too good though. Artie Burns, and then Darren Thompson, and Jack Thompson. Specialist, Spencer Lanning. I don't punt a lot. Like, unless I'm like back like 30 or 20 yards, so it's always not that good. And Jeff Heath, Randall, McDaniel, Alex Collins is my, oh, there he is. On power time. And Cordell Patterson is my, kick return. And Jeff Heath is my kicker, yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna get a better head coach. Nope. Okay. I actually wanna show you guys like a quick way to like make money. A lot of you probably already know this. So if I get here about 10 likes, just remind me in the comment section, and I'll make a whole video about it. Okay, guys. Peace. I'm out.
With the 4th. Here's Collins. Oh, and now he bolts, and he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Alex Collins.